اوكي بس so till the last class we done with the scripting and the hana as database. We learnt about hana as database and we dealt with all different kind of database objects like table, view, procedures, functions, column views and all those stuff. Now we're going to start with the hana modeling. Bus, please don't log in for waiting as name. Please log in with your name, bus. What, how many times I will tell you, bus? Can you all hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, boss. No, even if it doesn't ask you to log in with your name, when you right click on me, you have an option. When you right click on me, you have an option. Edit your name and email. When you drop down this option from your name, you have an option, edit your name and email ID, boss. Yeah. Okay, boss. Now we're going to start with SAP HANA modeling. Now as part of HANA modeling, we're going to deal with all these topics. One is about introduction, about what is modeling, why modeling, then about packages, then attribute and measures, then about information models, attribute view, analytical view, calculation view, where calculation view could be scripting based or graphical mode, then analytical privileges, then stored procedures and decision tables. This is what we're going to deal with as part of modeling. Now, what do you mean by modeling? Like, why should I go for modeling? HANA is a database. We are basically replicating data from, see, by using data processing techniques like SLT or BODS or whatever it is, we would replicate the data from different heterogeneous systems and push data into HANA. And then with that, you'll have all the data populated into your tables in HANA bus. Now, once we have the data in the tables, I can expose the tables to BO environment for IDT. Yeah, I'll cover BW on HANA also, after HANA, yeah. And then we can expose the tables in the BO environment and create an IDT universe and then do reporting on it. Okay, so once with the help of data processing techniques by using ETL tools or SLT or file imports or DXC, whatever it is, once I replicate the data from different heterogeneous systems and put the data into HANA tables, I can straight away start using those tables in IDT universe and build a universe on top of those tables, join those and then create reports. Then why do I need to go for modeling? First question. Okay. Okay. So this it goes like this. If you use the tables into the BO environment and create joins on those tables and then do all kind of massaging and then do reporting, when you fire a query in the BO environment, it reads the data from the tables from HANA database, but actual joining and all these manipulations is done at the application server, which is in the BO layer and then presented. If I do the other way, so since I've got modeling options in HANA, where I can do similar kind of modeling, what you do in IDT, like say, when I say modeling, it's about slicing and dicing. Let's say I have some 10 tables. Or these tables are not ready for consumption in the reporting. I would like to slice and dice my tables. Like say, in some of the tables, I would like to add new columns. In some of the columns, tables, I would like to apply filtering of some data. Then in some of the tables, I would like to rename the column name so that business understands it. All this, like say in some column tables, I want to hide up some of the columns not to be showing, whatever, filtering, joining multiple tables, filtering the data in the tables, or deriving new columns, calculating new columns, or restricting certain columns, or projecting only certain columns of the table. All these is what we call as modeling, slicing and dicing of the database completely to present the view what my business wants. So I can achieve all these things as part of HANA modeling. If I do this as part of HANA modeling, and if you consume the HANA models in the universe or in the BO, when you run your reports, it puts pressure onto HANA apps. So entire processing of data, processing of these views is carried out in HANA database, and then it gives you the results first. So since HANA is considered to be in-memory database with more powerful engines, with calculation engine, OLAP engines, we expect to have good performance on the reporting when compared to consuming the tables in the IDT universe and then designing and running the reports, where you're putting pressure on the application server in BO. So if you put pressure on BO comparatively when you're putting pressure on the HANA database, you'll see difference on the performance because of the in-memory database and the engines. Okay. Okay, boss. So this is what we would refer it as modeling. Okay. Okay. Now, in BW, you refer it as characteristic or key figure, right? And same way in BO environment, you refer it as a dimension and a measure. Here, as part of HANA modeling, we use this vocabulary as attribute and measure. Attribute is nothing but your characteristic in BW or dimension in BO. And measure is nothing but your key figure in BW and nothing but measure in your BO bus. Okay. So, any descriptive information or any business subject is referred as attribute, and anything which can be quantified, which can be measured out, we call that as measure, like revenue, quantity, all this would become a measure. Okay, so when you want to perform modeling, as we all know, within HANA Studio, we go to have multiple perspectives, like HANA development perspective, modeler perspective, BW modeling, ABAP, debug perspective, all this, administration perspective. Yeah. So as when you want to perform modeling in HANA, when you want to go about creating your HANA modeling, we would use HANA modeler as the perspective. Okay. Now this is how it looks now. If when we saw about database, it was all about organizing catalog objects as part of schema. You have a schema, then under each of the schema we had different type of objects, like different type of database objects organized, right? Same way as part of when you want to deal with HANA modeling, we go into this content folder. We work on this content folder, HANA modeling content folder. And as part of this content folder, you see you go creating a lot of objects. All the objects in your HANA modeling content will be organized as part of packages. These are called as packages. All the HANA modeling content will be organized as part of packages. It's similar to your folder. Package is nothing but just like a folder in your server. It's not a folder in your own system. It's a folder in your repository, in the server system. Okay. And then under this folder, you can go about having your attribute views, analytical views, calculation views, or privileges, or procedures, or your decision table. All these objects can be handled as part of this content folder as part of modeling. So basically, when you want to go about creating these views, you have to go about creating your packages. And once the package is created, under this package, you go about creating your HANA models. Okay. Okay. See, I'm just trying to explain, give a overview on what is attribute view, what is analytical view, calculation view. But what are the definition I give here? It's not the exact one. It is just making you to get the feel of what it is. But this is not exact meaning of this, okay? Now, when you say attribute views, it is similar to your master data in bw4s. It is similar, somewhat similar to master data in bw. Or if you look at it, it's like a dimension with some attributes in bw4s. That is what we refer to as attribute view. So, now what do you mean by attribute view? It's like this. Any view, whether it is attribute view or analytical view or calculation view, we are going to slice and dice the database. When I say slice and dice the database, joining the multiple tables or deriving a new column, calculating a new column or putting some restriction on the table, applying through filters or making some calculation dynamic into it, or you're just projecting only hiding some of the columns of the table, anything like, say you go about slicing and dicing the entire table set or all the database objects. And at the end of the session, so you should be able to project the columns what my business wants as part of the reporting environment. That is what it will be modeling. So when you say attribute view, when you want to do slicing and dicing of the database tables to project the data or to project the columns which represents certain entity or a stronger entity, which we call that as attribute view. For example, I would slice and dice all the tables and then do lot of massaging on the tables and then project certain columns like, say, customer number, customer name, address, region, all the details of the customer. Then I would say this view is actually giving information about an entity called customer, stronger entity called customer. So we call that as an attribute view. Okay. Same thing. Next we have analytical view. You can understand which is more like a cube in BW. See, not exact, but something similar. Because cube will hold data physically, but your analytical view will not hold data physically again. So, don't take it like that. Just for simulation, that's it. Something like cube in BW or your fact table in BW4s when you create columns. So, when you say analytical view again, when you say view, it's about slicing and dicing of your database tables and projecting certain columns to the reporting requirement, through which, if you're able to, through your providing reporting requirement, which involves fact data into it, which involves transaction data into it, then we call that as analytical views. We refer it as analytical view. So, when I want to do slicing and dicing of database or the tables, and then project certain columns to the reporting requirements, which basically contain the transaction data into it, then it have to go into analytical views. And point to be noted, analytical view can only deal with single fact table at a time. So when I create an analytical view, we can only refer one transaction data table. When I say transaction table is something from where you're referring facts or from where you're referring measures. So whenever I'm creating analytical view, you can only refer single fact table. When I say single fact table, a fact table is a table from where you're referring measures from. Because I might be using lot of transaction tables, transaction data tables, but I can refer measures only from one table only when it comes to analytical views. Okay. The next similar way, we also have a calculation view. Now you can understand more like a multi-provider or info set in BW. Or you can understand more like a virtual cube or whatever, virtual cube based on function model, all this can be done. So for now, just take this saying, whatever I can do achieve with attribute view, we can achieve with calculation view. Whatever we can achieve with analytical view, I can still achieve with calculation view. And much more complex scenarios also can be implemented. For example, I wanted to build a modeling, I wanted to do a modeling on the tables, where I wanted to refer measures from two fact tables, two transaction tables. I can't achieve that with analytical view. I have to go with calculation view. So whatever I could do with attribute view, I can still go ahead and do with calculation view. Whatever I could do with analytical view, I can still do that with calculation view. So So the major focus is on calculation views. In the latest versions, they have improvised much more options into calculation views. That's where through using calculation view, I have able to achieve every option what I could do with attribute view or analytical views. They have not improvised much in those two, attribute or analytical view. So keeping this point in focus, I feel in next future versions, they might stop attribute view or analytical view, not giving much preference. It will be focused on calculation views. Because, and that's where, if you see HANA Live, which is a ready-made content delivered by SAP as part of HANA models, you will see everything is a calculation view. Everything is a calculation view. Keeping those two points, in the latest versions, they have improvised much more options into calculation view. And all the HANA Live, when I say HANA Live, it's a ready-made business content, HANA models delivered by SAP, that contains everything is a calculation view in it. So seeing these two points, not live, HANA live, L-I-V-E, live, yeah. Keeping these two points in mind, I feel the major focus is on calculation view in future or now, as of now and future also, okay. So whatever you can't achieve with attribute or it can be achieved with calculation views. And, okay, simple example could be when you want to refer the measures from multiple fact tables, you can only do that with calculation view only. And moreover, as part of calculation view, they have given flexibility of graphical as well as scripting base also. So in case of calculation view, I can do graphical modeling, drag and drop, and then do design my views. Or I also have the flexibility of writing SQL scripting. That is why I was focusing more on scripting before we come to modeling. So we also have flexibility of writing SQL scripting and create your calculation views also. Because that is where you'll have a lot of value. When you say I'm good at HANA, you should be able to write scripting when it comes to calculation view also. Because when you say graphical modeling, you would have limited options. When you want to go beyond the options what is given as part of graphical and achieve the reporting requirements, you end up writing scripting. That's where you have to be really strong. Okay. So only when you're strong with scripting, you will be able to handle the calculation view or analytical view or attribute views. Okay. That's where I was, that will have a lot of value, I'm saying. Scripting will have a lot of value. Is it HANA Live? HANA Live, okay. Now what is HANA Live, L-I-V-E? HANA Live is nothing but ready-made HANA content delivered by SAP. Say, you have a lot of tables, you want to do slice and dice, you go to creating models, right? Same way, instead of you creating models, for most of the frequently required scenarios, SAP has given some ready-made HANA models as part of rapid deployment solutions, RDS, which we call that as HANA Live. So in real time, what we do, we don't use HANA Live directly. We take the HANA Live, create a copy of it, and then try to customize it as per the requirements. Yes, exactly. It is like business content. I'll show you. So can we modify a stored procedure? That's what I'm saying. You can modify a stored procedure, what is written in your modeling content, because it has got design time object and runtime object. Okay. Why do we need analytical view when calculation is doing everything? Good. Excellent. I said whatever you can achieve with analytical view, I can do that with calculation view. But still, if I need to do a modeling on a single fact table, I will still prefer analytical view because of two things. One is the operation of aggregation, because analytical view will use OLAP engine and calculation view will use calc engine. And for OLAP engine, aggregation is fast, very fast. So when I use single fact table and my analytical view gives me good performance of aggregation, I would prefer analytical view. If it is multiple fact tables, I have no option other than going to calc views. And there's one more point about input parameters. I'll come back to that later. You can understand like input parameter is something like your, I should not say variable in BW, but something like a filter. What happens is, say, in analytical view, when you don't pass any value to input parameter, like something like prompt, not exactly, because there is another concept called variables, not exactly prompts. Yeah. You can say like @ prompts what you use in derived views. It is something like that. Using @ prompts within the derived view, that is what input parameters are. Yeah. They go inside SQL. Yeah. So when you do this, in case of analytical view, when I don't pass any value for a input parameter in analytical view, it will still return all the values for it. But in calculation view, when I don't pass any value for a input parameter, it does return no values. For example, I have a column called country. On country, I create input parameter. In calculation view, if you don't pass anything, if I make it as optional and if you don't pass any value, it returns no value bus. Same way in analytical view, if I have a prompt and input, sorry, not prompt, input parameter, even if I don't pass, it is going to return me all the countries. So there is a difference in the behavior of input parameter when compared to analytical view and calculation view. These two points I see difference in analytical view where it makes sense. Is it? Yes, it is like filters. Yes, yes, planning level filters. Okay, boss. Okay. You'll understand more on what these views are when you see more into that. Okay. Some other question. I think I answered. Yeah, like business content. Let me just show you. So that is very important. Because in most of, sorry, I did not take the team viewer. One second. Okay, boss. I think now here you can see it. Even I have installed the HANA demo content, which is HANA Live. Yeah. If you go to this package SAP, HBA, and I've got content for ECC, CRM and all those. If I go to ECC, if you look at this ready-made HANA Live content delivered by SAP, it has got all calculation views. Look at this. There's no, not even single attribute view or analytical view. It's all calculation. So your focus should be on calculation views. Who will install HANA Live? This is very simple. We can install it. This is just importing views. See, so this is all HANA Live views. All these are ready-made views delivered by SAP. Yeah. Okay. Who will install HANA Live? I think we can install HANA Live. That's not, that is just about importing a package. We can do that because basis will not know about this. We'll have to download this from the service marketplace and import this, import the delivery unit. Okay. Okay. Then we have something called analytical privileges. Procedures also there in HANA. Yeah, yeah. There are some ready-made functions I told you. See, not only there is something called AFL. I told you in the beginning, application function library. Okay, which will have two things: predictive analytics library and business function library. These are nothing but the ready-made procedures which are delivered by SAP. We just have to call them. But what the procedures, what you are seeing are procedures used for the ready-made HANA Live content. Okay. Okay, next is analytical privileges, okay. So when you say analytical, is the business content in live already available for all models given by SAP? Yeah, pretty much, yes. Pretty much, yes, but you they don't really satisfy majority of the requirements. You can basically create a copy of them and then you customize it, okay. Okay, that's what, can we customize the objects we use? Yes, we basically create a copy of those views and then customize it. Okay. How do we search for the ready-made views that are already available in HANA Live ready-made modules? In bw4hana for queries and reports are available in HANA Live. You can use HANA Live, but see, there is a point here. What is HANA Live? HANA Live is nothing but ready-made HANA views delivered by SAP or ready-made HANA models. Now what is your attribute view, analytical view, calculation? These are HANA model. What do? They have to refer to the data from some of the tables and then do massaging to those tables or do slicing and dicing of those tables and then project the columns what is required for the business. Now look at the logic here. If I need to give some ready-made view, should I freeze what table should be used in it? Yes. When there is a ready-made view delivered by SAP, the tables what is used inside the view is fixed. Yes. If that is the case, what they have done is they assume that you're replicating all the data from ECC to HANA, or you're working on ECC on HANA, where HANA database already has all the tables relevant to ECC, then these views can go and sit on those, on top of those tables. If look at these HANA models from ECC, one which you understand, look at this now. There is a view called VBUK.com which will sit on what? Which table is this? VBUK table. So before I bring in these views into my HANA database, I must make sure I have those relevant tables which is already used in the views are available in my HANA database. Otherwise, from which table will it pick the data from? So you'll have HANA Live content for ECC, CRM, retail. There have been some specifics like that. So depending on the application, what you're working on, you would basically make sure you have all the tables relevant to the application already available in the HANA database. Because if you look at ECC on HANA, all the database of ECC system is already sitting on the respective HANA database. So that HANA database will have a scheme, ECC schema, which will have all the ECC tables in it. You just have to import this HANA Live, which will sit on top of those tables and then expose them for reporting. You don't need BW. But that will work out in a customer space where the customer has got only single ECC system. But if you have to integrate data from multiple applications, then again, that's a different case. Yeah. Say for example, there is a customer with CRM on HANA, then I can leverage HANA Live content, because when I have CRM on HANA database, all the data dictionary of CRM is sitting on the HANA database in one schema, in CRM schema. So all the tables are already there in the HANA. I don't have to replicate it again. Then I just have to install HANA Live content for CRM, which will go and sit on top of those data schema of CRM system. Then the HANA Live will start playing and then I can start exposing them for reporting. That's their target. Yeah. In BW, okay, it's only views, not like queries readily available in business content in BW. This very good. Look at this question. He says, first of all, you should understand about HANA Live now. So if I want to leverage HANA Live for ECC, then what should I have? I should have ECC on HANA, where all the data dictionary of ECC system will sit on one schema bus. Now look at this now. I don't know whether I have this SAP GUI here or not. It's a different system here. Yeah, I have. Now let me show you this. So let me go to bw4hana, okay? Say cubex and I go to the system. Last day for expiry, okay, good. Now this is my bw4hana system. So if I look at the system properties, status, look at this. You'll have same way ECC on HANA, nothing difference. It says database is HDB. So for this BW SAP Native Your System, the backend is HANA database. And so it is SP9 or so on. So the system ID is SP9 and the instance is 01 and the server database server is SAP Cubex. And look at this, there's something like owner, SAP ABAP 1. Okay, now let's go get into, this is the HANA database for me, of my BW backend. Yeah? So I can go to the back system and look at this. This is, look at the system here. SAP Cubex was a server, SP9 was a system ID and 01 was the instance. Okay, within that, I had a owner called SAP ABAP 1. That is nothing but your schema. I can call this as BW schema for BW schema. See, I have a schema called ABAP 1. This is what I call it as BW schema. The entire data dictionary of BW, all the tables would be still available. For example, I go and search for some fact table here. Slash BAC slash F, I would say. F is a fact table. So do I find some fact tables here? See, I see a lot of fact tables for Q1, Q2, Q3. What is this? This is all data dictionary of your the BW system, which is sitting on top of this HANA databases. Same way, when you look at ECC on a HANA system, when you log into ECC, you will find that the underlying database is HANA and it will have a owner. That is nothing but the schema. So when I get into the underlying database and open that schema, I will find all the data dictionary, all the tables of ECC like VBAC, VBUK, KNA1, LFA1, VBAP, VB, all the tables within the ECC schema in HANA database. When all my tables are already there, why should I replicate it on another system? No need of any ETL or no provisioning. Straight away, I'll install HANA live in that HANA database, where this HANA model, ready-made HANA models will sit on the same tables which is in the ECC schema. Then I can start plug and play. I can start using those views for reporting. This is the concept. Did I make it clear what is schema, what is HANA live now? Now we can answer this question. Anil was asking, okay, look at this question. It says, in bw4hana, we have ready-made queries available. So is it like only views or only queries? Now with BW 7.4 SP11, you can straight away create a BEX report on my view directly. With BW 7.4 SP11, you can straight away create a BEX query on top of HANA view directly. Or if you don't want to go with BEX query, I can consume this view directly in a analysis for OLAP without any query. Straight away I can consume this HANA live or HANA views in HANA analysis for OLAP view or design studio. Straight away I can consume that view. Only for web report you will have to create a universe and then access it. Even that they are going to fix it so that you don't need any universe. Straight away you can start consuming views. Okay, customers fact tables as well. Yeah, of course. Column view, right? Sai Mukesh, what was that question? Column view in the sense? These are not column view, these are fact tables, normal tables. And even when you activate your HANA live, it would definitely create column views in SysBig schema. Okay. What are fact tables? Those are tables. Don't worry on what is fact. If you're not from BW background, don't get into that concept. What I mean to say is, I have underlying applications. See, HANA is a database, so I can use it as a backend. So for this BW, I've used some as a backend also. So let's say, in the front end application of BW, I see some table. /BIC/F cube 1. This is my table. So what I mean to say is, what does it say? Not there. I think 01. This 01. So I see this is a table in my application. And this table is ultimately sitting in what? HANA database. See, this was happening even when I had VW with SQL Server or DB2 bus. Only thing is, we never used to log into the database because my application was stronger than the database in those cases. But now I'm logging into database because my database is stronger than my application bus. That was the case. You getting what I'm saying? See, I don't know whether I have the other one. If I look at the normal BW system, I think it's not, I have switched it off. No bus. I can show. See, if you look at normal BW system which is running on SQL Server or something, you will still see the database as SQL Server, it will have a schema, it will have all those, okay. But only thing is, we never used to log into the database, we never worried about database because my application was stronger than the database. But with BW on HANA or ECC on HANA or CRM on HANA or APO on HANA, we are trying to log into the database because database is stronger than the application. That's the point here. Okay, good. Next, sir, when we have HANA S4, then ECC schema is not required for modeling. See, what is S4 HANA, what is ECC schema? See, yes, don't get confused. When you say HANA is a database, when you say BW on HANA, it's like BW application running on HANA. When you say ECC on HANA, ECC application running, you have installed ECC with HANA database. Till now we've been installing all this with SQL Server or DB2 or Oracle or whatever it is. Now we can install that on top of HANA bus. So when you say ECC on HANA, I'm installing ECC application on HANA database. When I say CRM on HANA, and we are installing CRM application on top of HANA. When you say APO on HANA, it's like you're installing APO application on top of HANA database. That's it. Okay. Now you know what is HANA is a database, BW on HANA, ECC on HANA, you understand this. Now the question is, now next question, S4 HANA. What is S4 HANA? See, when I say S4 HANA, it is more like an ECC on HANA, more compatible. See, what they have done is, what SAP says, now look at this. Look at the point on what S4 HANA is. It's nothing different, okay? What SAP says is, if you look at SAP ECC, there are n number 60,000 plus tables in the backend to store different kind of information because they wanted to make the database more normalized. That's where they had 60,000 plus tables where they wanted to remove redundancy and they made it more normalized databases. Okay, because we are using normal other databases. But now what SAP feels is, once we have HANA as a backend database, we don't have to worry about data being denormalized. Irrespective of whether data is normalized or denormalized or duplicate, not duplicate, however it is stored. Since HANA has got columnar storage of data, it can handle the performance. That is a point of proof. So based on this point, what SAP has done is, they wanted to get back to denormalized database. Generally, when they develop application, the database will be normalized because you can store more data with less space. But with my columnar storage table in the backend for my HANA, I don't have to really worry about database being normalized because even though my table is denormalized, in case of columnar storage, the amount of space required to store will be less because it stores only distinct values of the column. So having this point, and performance is also handled because of columnar storage. Having this point in mind, what SAP is trying to do is, they want to simplify the database. They don't want to have 60,000 plus tables. They've identified all the tables where most of the columns are not used. Even if you see most of the customer ECC, you see lot of the columns in the tables are blank, left out blank. You all agree with that? If you look at BSEC or MSEC, you still see lot of columns not really being used at all. So they have removed all the unwanted columns from all the databases, tables, and they started denormalizing. Instead of storing one particular information, for example, MKPF and MSEC, in two tables, they have combined into one table. Like this, they went about denormalizing tables and reducing the tables, and they say, now we have 13 tables only. It has been denormalized to that level. So, ECC application, more simplified database, more simplified application processing is what we call that as S4HANA. So, more optimized ECC towards HANA in case of denormalizing the database, reducing the data dictionary, reducing the tables, reducing the application processing, simplifying the application processing, that is what we call it as S4HANA. That's where you hear about simplified finance. Yeah, they're going to come out with all models like simplified finance, simplified purchasing, simplified procurement. They're going to come out with all those like that. That will be more into, that is what they refer to as S4HANA. So in going forward, the approach of SAP after 4 to 5 years approach would be that once S4HANA clicks in, it is more simplified. I have all the processing done in S4 and I have all the data stored in S4HANA only with less number of tables, like 13 to 15. And on the same tables, they'll give HANA models, and the same HANA models will be used for reporting. So it will be one single system for OLTP as well as analytics also. So they want to, then that gives more real-time data processing. So that is what they're ultimately up to. They want to have one single environment for transaction processing as well as analytics. So I think I made sense. If ECC tables are already available in relevant schema like BW schema, then why have we need to import them into HANA? Good question. Very good questions. Look at what Amol says. Look at the question he is saying. In case of BW on HANA, he is looking at the environment where he has got BW on HANA. I'll have a BW schema in HANA database. If that schema already has those tables, now first question, why will it have those tables? Whatever the tables I see in BW schema in HANA will be the tables what is available in the BW application. In BW, do you have tables like VBAC, VBAP, VBUP, KN1, LFM1, all this? No, right? These are the data dictionary of ECC bus. So you have BW sitting on top of HANA, you have ECC sitting on top of HANA. When I log into the HANA database of ECC, in the ECC schema, I will see all the tables relevant to ECC application. When I log into HANA database, which is actually the backend of BW, then in the BW schema, I will see all the tables relevant to BW applications. So in BW schema, how would you expect me to see tables of ECC bus? No? Okay, got this. So since I will not have those tables in my BW schema, which is sitting on top of HANA, those tables are available in ECC. Either two options, you either install HANA live content within the HANA database of ECC and do reporting directly, or replicate all the SAP ECC relevant tables into BW or HANA database, then implement HANA live in BW or HANA, then do reporting. Okay. Improvisation of ECC is what S4HANA, okay. Instead of updating in multiple tables for the same transaction in ECC through S4HANA for each model, SAP is minimizing number of tables so that the transaction data is saved. Yes, excellent. That is what they're trying to do. See, first thing is, as of today, ECC has got 60,000 plus tables, where most of the columns are left blank. No company is using it at all. So they have removed all those unwanted columns from the dictionary, and then they have reduced the number of columns to be used, simplified the database, and they have made it more denormalized by bringing all of them into single table. So that, because even though database is normal, even the table is normalized, it is still handled in case of an HANA system, where because HANA supports columnar storage, even though data is duplicate, redundant, it is still not wasting space because in columnar storage, it stores only distinct values, right? That's the point, and it can still handle the performance. That's where they're reducing the number of tables. Okay, I got it. if we denormalize the table, size will grow. Excellent question, Sai Mukesh. He says, if we denormalize the tables, the database size will grow, but it will not grow in case of columnar storage bus. Since redundancy will be there in tables, how does S4HANA handles it? Now, that's what I was explaining you. I was saying, in case of S4HANA, you will have data stored into the database, is fine, which is denormalized, but all those tables will be columnar storage of database. So that's there. Okay, you go, okay, got the answer. Okay. So if it is columnar, no redundancy, it will store only distinct values of the column and the performance is fine. Okay. Okay. So in future, no more ECC and BW. Can we use S4HANA to replace both? So answer is yes and no also. Yes, in case of customers who has got only ECC applications. No, in case of customers who has to integrate data from n number of applications, then no. If look at customers like BMW, who actually integrates data from almost 360 applications, which are SAP as well as non-SAP, mainframes, Java, different systems. For this kind of scenario, you cannot replace all the applications with S4HANA. In that case, you still have to go with BW or HANA only, where you use BW as a consolidation layer, as a warehouse. Okay. Does BW data stores data store twice? I don't understand this, Mahesh. Does BW data stores twice? Can we see any problem landscape like S4HANA, BW on HANA and ECC on HANA? It is still, see, ECC on HANA is fine. S4HANA is still on the mature, not still yet matured. SAP announces it to be improvising it a lot on it. But ECC on HANA pretty much fine. Okay. Even in n number of applications like BMW, we may not need ECC anymore. Yeah, for processing, you might go with S4 because if you look at BMW, they've got 12 plants. They've got 6 plants with SAP and remaining other plants, they've got mainframes or different applications. Then for these 6 plants, you can look at having S4HANA. Others still have to go with non-SAP only. Then I need to have one data warehouse which consolidate about data about all these plants. So then I still need to have BW there in that case. In HANA and BW, what was that question? I did continuation. Does data BW stores twice? No. Don't get confused. BW does he is asking? Very good question. Yeah, you have to get clarified on all this. He's saying I have BW on HANA system. I have BW application which is running on HANA database. Okay, which is running on HANA database. Then in that case, you're able to see the data in SC11 in BW, you're able to see the data in the schema in HANA also. Now the question is saying, so when I see data in SC11 and I can see data in HANA database BW schema, so is it storing twice? No. Whatever you're seeing in SC11 is actually picking it from the BW schema from HANA only. Because SC11 is an application. So when I click show me the content, see when I click on this show me the content from here, it is actually reading the data from the BW schema of HANA database and then showing me. It is reading from the BW schema from HANA and then showing me, okay? Yeah, 6 plants as in different regions. Yes, different regions. Yeah. Okay, boss. Is it clear now? HANA live, ECC on HANA, how that will be placed? Yeah. Okay, good. Can we see the schema name in BW? Yes, I showed you, no? See, system, go to the status. You see this, owner. Owner name, nothing but SAP. Okay, within the BW system or any SAP application which is running on HANA database, you'll also have a T code called DBA underscore cockpit. In any SAP application which is running on HANA database, whether it is ECC, CRM or BW, APO, whatever it is, you will see a T code called DBA underscore cockpit. Okay, very good. DBA cockpit. Here you can see the primary connection of your application towards the backend database. When you go there, you can see the primary database connection to your database. If you see this, if you say display, it clearly tells you to which system it is using, what is the system it is connecting to. Database SP9, the schema is SP1, the host is the server name, and the revision of the database is 96 is the revision. See, 96 in other words, so SP9 with 96 is the revision. Yeah, and that's how see HANA version 1, and then support pack is 96 revision. That's what we see. You can see all the details, the primary connection. See, BW is an application, HANA is a database, so there should be some connection between that. So the primary connection of database is what we see here. Okay, and the view it picks up backend of HANA. Sorry, what was the question? Can we see the schema? Done. Okay, but the tables are row store or column? All the tables relevant to BW application would be a columnar storage. You can see here all the tables. Any table you get in, all the tables will be columnar storage. All the tables relevant to application pretty much will be, see, look at this here. You see it's a column store. Everything is column store. All the tables are called. Okay. Okay, and the view it picks of backend of HANA. What? I didn't understand this. What? Okay, the view it picks of backend of HANA. What is this program? I didn't understand. Sorry. I missed it.
So, like, I meant to say, like, for example, you said, like, the SAP ABAP one would be the schema, right? So, like, for example, whenever you are trying to pull some data from SC11, it would be picking from some particular view. From backend, right, from SAP HANA, can we see that, like any kind of structure doing that?
If it is table, see, this is the table, even in HANA, I can see the content here, I can open, I can see the content of this table, and the same content you will see in S11, no difference. But we never used to do this because we never used to log into database well before, when we had BW on SQL Server. We never used to log into the database. That was a problem.
Yes.
If you want, I can show you to really clarify it on, like if I can connect other system. I think my normal BW which is running on SQL is down, but so that is down. Otherwise, I could have shown, even if I can log into SQL Server, if you look at BW which is running on SQL Server, I can explicitly log into SQL Server and show you that schema, then show you the tables there also. Yeah. But we never used to do that because BW was stronger than SQL Server database. Now we are doing because logging into database, because database is stronger than the application. That's the point. Yeah. SP9 we are on, but what is 96 is revision. See, one is the version, HANA version 1. And 96 is the revision. 96 indicates it is SP9. Okay. SP9 is actually was the system ID. Okay. But 96 indicates it's a version 9, support pack 9 with 96 is the revision. Okay. We call it the revision. So when BW running on HANA and we are also using HANA Studio, so whenever we create new queue or DSO, then it will be available in HANA Studio automatically. See, HANA Studio is also front-end application that will not have anything. That's only screens. HANA Studio is only screen. When you log into HANA Studio, you can connect to the HANA database and work on it. So when you connect to the HANA database and when you see the objects in the BW schema, you will find the table. That's how you should understand. You should not understand I can get tables in Studio. HANA Studio is only screens. Or is a simple platform through which you get connected to HANA database and work on it. So once I create my DSO or fact table or whatever it is, or cubes, it creates all the relevant tables in your HANA database in BW schema. So if you explicitly want to see, you can see that in SC11, or you can explicitly want to log into database, with HANA Studio, I can get connected to HANA database, get into the BW schema and look at those tables also. Yeah, okay. In my customer, I am seeing it is HANA 2 version bus. It is HANA 2 version, HANA 2, okay. It is HANA version 2, okay. Not 1.x, it is 2.x. More latest, yeah. Only system table or row store, only in HANA, in HANA database, only system tables or row store, yes, yeah. 2.0.013 means version 13. No. Version 2, SP 13, support pack 13. Okay. So can we use row-based tables in analytical? No. Very good question. He's asking, can I use row-based tables in your HANA modeling? No. Only column store tables can be used. SQL Server means it's a database. I was referring to MS SQL Server database. That's it. Yeah. Don't get confused. I'm just referring to some database. If you have multiple EC systems, how do we store them in HANA? Can we use single HANA system? Excellent question, Mahesh. He's asking, I have got multiple EC systems. Can I make all of them to sit on a single HANA database? Excellent question. We have a possibility. But there is also a restriction. What they do is they install HANA database and they can create multiple instances within that. Within one HANA database server, we can create multiple instances. Okay, for example, if you look at this, look at mine. I have got SP9. I also have got SP8. These two are two different system IDs, but both are on the same server only. And this is acting, SP9 is acting as a backend for one database, one system, and SP8 is acting as a backend for another system. But both are from same HANA server only. So multiple instances on same server, but probably in the real time, they may not go about doing like this. Yeah. Has nothing to do with SP9 or SP12. Okay. No. This is version 2 bus. Okay. Is there any other tool other than HANA modeler tool in my product? The GUI of HANA modeling looks different than here. That's so, because even HANA Studio has got multiple versions, 101, 104, depends on what version of HANA Studio you've implemented. That is one. We can also implement with Eclipse also. You can take this from SAP, or you can take this from Luna. There are different vendors who can give Eclipse tool. Depending on from which vendor you install, that also depends on. Okay. If you've taken this from Luna, it will be different ones. SP13, let me see straight away. Why should we have all the doubts whether 13 is out or not? Why? Because you're asking me this a lot of times. Let me fix it for once. platform addition 1 and it is SP12. Let me just sort it down. June 2016. I see it as SP12. So, platform addition, it's SP12. Yeah, I see it as SP12, which is 100121, which is 121 revision, which is version 1, 121 is a revision. 121 revision is part of SP support pack 12, okay. But I don't know where I'm seeing is 2. Version 2 SP, does that mean, no, I don't see that, but might be that I don't have access to the latest version, but not sure on that, but here it shows SP12 as the latest version. Sir, how to grant privileges to the new user created under the system database so that we can create procedure under content? I'm not able to create the procedure under contents. You're not, see, when you're trying to create a procedure, very important, when you're trying to create a procedure on the schema what you've created, you cannot create it directly, so you have to execute this statement, select, or you can say grant, you have to use this grant on grant select on schema, your name of the schema, your schema name, to use your username with grant option. You have to execute this statement so that then, sorry, this is not your username, this is to your sysrepo user, underscore sys. So you do this, you have to grant select on your schema to sysrepo user so that he is the one who actually maintains the complete modeling content in the repository content. So he should have access to those, your schema, then you'll be able to create that. HANA plan visualization, is it different tool from HANA model? No, it's not a different tool. It's actually part of HANA Studio only, which will show you graphical representation of the execution plan of the model. For example, I write some, say, I have this procedure. I have this select. I would like to see graphical representation of it. So I can just right click and say visualize plan. That will take you to plan visualization and it will show you the list of operations carried out graphically. It says column search. If you expand this, so it is going to, as per the procedure selection, it is going to read data from this table where customer ID is less than 5, then project the column. This operation it is going to do. If you want to see the runtime operations, you can say execute. You can see the executed plan and how much time it has taken at each operation. You can see this. You can see with the results here. Scroll down and you can expand at each. It totally has taken 1.4 seconds. Then if you go inside, and it gets you for each operation how much time it has taken. Then you can get in and see what all operations were carried out in detail. It has checked the delta, any changes, acquire table logs, then it is reading, then it is doing column search, all this. This is visualized planning. Graphically looking at the operations list, what has been carried out when you perform an operation is what visualized plan is, okay. Yeah, it's a different perspective. That's do we need to run about grant command on normal user or system schema? On your schema, what you have created to sysrepo user. Now, if you still have doubts, finish it off first today. At least tomorrow you can focus on modeling. You took me out somewhere else first completely. Yeah, any more doubts? Okay. So we'll stop it here and tomorrow we'll connect again. Okay, fine. Thanks. Sir, if you don't mind, can you please give a brief difference between ECC HANA and I chipna kadappa ECC HANA SC. As a shortcut, ECC is like ECC application running on HANA. S4HANA is also S4 application running on HANA. So what is S4 is more optimized ECC towards HANA with more simplified database and simplified application processing. That is S4HANA. Okay.